In all fairness to the bidder, I think you should request the press not to publish if they have the information. Otherwise, it violates his due process.
That's what I'm going to do. I mean, and all we can do is we're going to ask the two press that are here if they would, if I can pay it up. Yes, they have that knowledge up here, but we just ask them not to publish it. But if that's what the council is at.
I don't have a problem with that, but as long as you proceed, it's still public record.
Oh, and I think it will be public record in public form regardless of what record.
So if I hear what you're saying, Dave, is we want to have this reviewed by an engineer by our next meeting so we can move forward on this.
Well, I think we need to have it reviewed.
The code.
The code review to see if we need to have an engineer. And it should be a fairly simple review. You know, like I said, I really need to open this can of worms.
Did you say that threshold between 40 and 100,000?
Yeah.
And it says that, you think it says that if it falls in that category, even though we're just getting quotes?
Yeah.
That it has to be the plan?
Yes.
Even on maintenance or repair?
It doesn't matter. Unfortunately, it's any project that falls into that dollar threshold. That's what I say, that's my interpretation is, as I went back and looked at it. And I absolutely could be wrong. I've certainly been wrong before.
Would you like for me to read you the section of chapter 26?
No, I think.
It says prepared by, not approved by.
I think that's why I said.
And you should consult an attorney.
That's what I'm asking for.
All right.
Good.
So we can just table this
for
2 weeks until we get that answer.
They're going to take no action.
Yeah, just take no action.
We're going to acknowledge the basically.
Yeah.
Somebody else, and we do nothing with them until we get back to you. Okay, Doug, report by the administrator.
Okay, one of the first things I want to talk about is that there's some things coming down from the state, particularly on electrical, and we may have to adopt the new 2008 electrical code to satisfy state requirements. But I would like to, we have never had a meeting of the Building Board of Appeals, and that was one of their functions, as described in our ordinance, that they would consult, you know, make recommendations to the council on various and sundry matters of such type. So I think we need to have a meeting of the Building Board of Appeals along with Jim, myself and the mayor, whoever else wants to attend, and talk about some of these new regulations that are coming down the pike and get back to the council with recommendations on what we should do, what we should adopt. So if there's no objections, I'll go ahead and call a meeting at the Building Board of Appeals so that they can do that. You probably noticed we're going to do some new landscaping on the front side of the rec center over here. Those bushes were old and rank, and we took those out. We cut a couple of trees down that were not, they weren't good. I mean, they were sweating and so on and so forth. We left the one tree there with the memorial tree with the plaque and all that, and we're going to re-landscape that with, Mike's got pictures where we've got it all drawn out and there's two copies. It's old and new ones up there. And should look really nice when we get that one. The materials are here, I'll purchase. The pool grates are going to be installed this week, sometime this week, what they told us. And the back alert that we have to put in for the baby pool is not not in yet, but they hope to have it by the time we're ready to open for the season. The estimate's about $1,500 to $1,600, which is a lot better than I thought it might be. You know, as far as complying with this Graham Baker Act. So I think we're getting in pretty good shape on that. I had a letter here from an email from Matthew Hours. He lives on Paradise Lane in Kelowna. He said he would like to host a fundraiser walk in Kelowna sometime this summer, either August 1st or August 8th. The event would start and end in the park with participants walking through and around Kelowna. It would be similar to the 5K run that Jim Caton does around Fall Festival time and would last a couple of hours in the morning. I told him we would talk a little bit about it tonight, and I would get back to him and tell him exactly what he needed. I don't know what the fundraiser is for, but I would assume he'd want to know what the fundraiser is for and what time it's going to start and all that kind of stuff. But this is just for you to think about it in the meantime, but he will get back with more details on it. That's really not all I've got to report on, I guess. Been mowing a lot of grass in the last few days. Going like crazy. Any questions about
there's two options on this landscape plan.
Well, one of them is the way it is now, and the other one's what we're planning to do.
The other one's option one is current. It says option one and option two.
It's option one is current.
That's current. Oh, I got old and new written on there.
Oh, there it is. Old. Okay. The only question I have, I could be wrong on this, but could somebody, I think I mentioned this before, just check to see if there's a protocol for where flag poles are located on a building. I've seen some stuff on that, and it's been a little while since I've looked at it, but I know there may be a protocol for what side of the building the flag goes on.
Yeah, that's right. I need to check on that, but we will before we move the flag pole or anything.
And I think we ought to get a new flag pole rather than a flag pole.
Well, we got a quote. Jim. We got a quote from a guy that, because we're going to take it down. A guy that would come in and sandblast it, and we galvanize it, and we paint it. Whether that would be satisfactory or not, I don't know. But the pulley is broken on the very top of it. Now we can't even get up there to get a flag put back on it now.
It's going to be there a long time. It might be a time to invest in some new equipment.
We haven't gotten that far yet right now. The reason we cut the trees down and pulled the brush down, we had a bunch of kids from the school here, and we dragged them out, and we had a lot of help to load them up on a truck to haul them out on Earth Day. So that'll all get cleaned up, and we can decide later what kind of landscaping or what kind of bushes or what you want to put in there. For right now, we just took them out because we had the opportunity to do it. It worked out. So.
Right down the pole, we're going to go into that little park.
Yeah. And that other tree needs to be, we need to get somebody in the tree that we're saving. We need to get in and tread them up around the top and all that. So, because it was in the way of the flag, I mean, it was. Yeah.